Ini record juga ya. Right. Okay, saya mula sekarang. Okay, Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum. So we continue. Are you recording or not? Lijiang?
Yes.
Alright. Assalamualaikum. Kita continue for part 2 of our ni product rendering and visualization. Okay, tadi I have explained to you about lecture lah based on the slide. I will slide to you later, share the slide to you later. So now we go for the actual thing lah, the procedure of doing that, how we do 3D rendering from our SolidWorks. Okay, if I share you my SolidWorks first, okay, can you see my SolidWorks file? Boleh nampak file ni, kelas?
Yes.
SolidWorks, boleh nampak? Nampak SolidWorks? Okay, ini adalah skateboard. This is a skateboard, okay, previous project, okay. So this is a SolidWorks. Standard view. It's a skateboard. Okay, skateboard. Remember, you already learned SolidWorks, right? In your previous engineering drawing class. Okay. This implemented mode. Okay. Better lah, guys. You buat dalam bila when you do for your final concept, you do your assemble of your product. You have, you know how to do this, right? Exploded mode. Already been talk to you kan, you already learn about this, how to do exploded mode, that's why I don't have to explain about this. Okay, you have two mode, better to go for two mode. I mean, satu lagi, we can collapse. Of course, you know this thing, collapse. Collapse is dalam assembly mode. And also, we have, kalau you right click, we go to explode mode, you have explode mode. Okay, explode mode is good for you to represent you punya rendering to show the internal component. For example, like say, for example, you punya product. For our case, like this one is a skateboard lah. Sorry, it's not relevant to you punya project. It's a hands-free device. And you punya project ni varies, depend on your group. Tapi like the one I can show this example like for your guideline. So you have a product. For example, this is your skateboard. You have all the components there. So it's good. Usually what you have two mode. One is product, one is assemble. When you collab, it's become full assemble. Yeah, explore more. You want to show you punya render. You want to share to explain about all the component involved. Sometimes when we are in assembly mode. When we are in assembly mode, we cannot show, explain to the client, to the people, again, what is the component beneath it, what is the component inside. It's a hidden component. We have a bearing, we have a kind of rubber damper inside to explain by assembly. So better in a spray work, you make both mode. Now you have exploded mode and you have a fully assembly. Okay, remember as I told you tadi, when you from live link, from Keyshot, ada yang guys. Boleh dengar saya ni? Boleh dengar? Just to make sure. Alright. Can you remember that I cakap you to install when you install Keyshot that you install under the additional plugin called Lifelink, Lifelink punya tu, Lifelink tu. So bila you install that Lifelink dengan SolidWorks tu, then ada sini, you will appear in the here, nampak tak sini? This one dia akan interact, this a Lifelink to your Keyshot. Nampak sini, you have four icon, you don't tell, you just use the first and second actually. But this one for this case, okay, already, that is my file here in SolidWorks. So I just click at the first icon. First icon means send to Keyshot, nampak tak? So whatever you can assemble mode, you can send to Keyshot assemble mode. When you collapse it in full assembly, you send to Keyshot, dia akan update. They will always like me. Bila you make you punya ni assemble mode, not explore mode, you click update. Update then in Keyshot directly you will update in assembly mode. So it's good. Dia ada communication lah, dia ada live link So okay, for this one I want it to be to exploded mode. So I just click on this one, send to Keyshot. Bila I send to Keyshot, automatically you will open the Keyshot and you hold on. Okay, yang ini you can see the Keyshot. Boleh nampak lah? Can eh?
Can.
Alright, this is Keyshot tapi hold on yang ini dia punya screen dia kecil pasal I already do some changing in my setting, so I set it again. Can you see this Keyshot so I got to my image resolution tu, I got to go for much bigger punya size pasal ni ke problem. Okay, kita nampak full screen ni, you can go for image resolution because I already do some, you can go for custom ni. If I go for setting 69 also, okay, this is a default setting. You can go in your image, solution, landscape. If I go for the standard one, this will be is what you punya, this is a setting that what you want to render in what quality. Let's say you want to render for A3. Let's say you want to render for M4. You got to set first your image to resolution to, let's say you want to go A4, so you will be A4. Tapi A4 ni, this later on, the view ni, the you punya viewport become small. So I change it to bigger one. Eh. Just later on, but I go for A4. So I go for something like, you can go for 920, 1200. Let's say I go for image, resolution, landscape for, go for, let's go for 69, the size of your viewport. Go for, let's say I go for bigger one. Okay, let's go. Ini is our viewport punya ni. Eh. Nanti kita reset, kita size of the ni. Alright, if you look in this interface, yeah, can you see that this is all Keyshot, eh? Keyshot, they have the interface and different from SolidWorks lah. And most of the 3D rendering practice lebih kuat interface is something like this. We have the center is our viewport lah, our scene, our scenery. And we have a pull down menu also. Eh? This is a Keyshot version 10, guys, and the latest one. Eh? So you install it, you try to install it, and you can open the Keyshot. Okay, we have pull down menu file for here something edit. Okay, guys, for okay. What I want to tell you, benda ni I explain to you just basic saja guys. Kita tak learn deeply Keyshot. I hope you understand. Just a rough introduction, basic introduction. At least you know how to do things in Keyshot by my video lah. Okay. So the center is your viewport. So we have a pull down menu like typically. Then we have kita punya tab ni. Kita punya tab ni. Never mind. I don't want to touch more detail about ni. Yang basic saya explain to you guys. Okay. Yang sekarang ni kita have a viewport. The center if your view portion, you can manipulate lah. You punya object. Okay. The way kita maneuvering I mean kita navigate the navigate in Keyshot lah. Macam SolidWorks. Kalau in SolidWorks, how do we do in SolidWorks? SolidWorks. Can you see my SolidWorks kan guys? Boleh nampak kan? Boleh nampak SolidWorks. SolidWorks, how do you navigate? Kalau kita zoom in, macam mana scroll wheel, zoom in, zoom out. How do we arch rotate? Arch rotate SolidWorks macam mana? You hold down your middle button mouse kan? Your middle button mouse or your scroll wheel, that is arch rotate. Kalau you panning, you control and middle button mouse, you hold down together, panning. Itu yang penting. Any 3D application, when you penting, the first thing, dia punya maneuvering lah, we call it navigation tu penting. Eh? Okay, for Keyshot, you zoom in, same as well, zoom in, zoom out to zoom in you punya ni lah, you punya product. To arch rotate, just simply left button mouse. Left button mouse you hold down, okay, the pick button mouse you hold down, it will navigate, this will arch rotate lah. You can focus on that. And for you to panning, just similar like SolidWorks, right? Okay, similar as well. You hold down your middle button mouse, you scroll, you press, and you hold down, that is panning. Okay, nampak tak dia punya orientation nampak, I'm in, can you see that I'm in apa? Exploded mode. The same kita punya axis tu the kind of XYZ like SolidWorks lah. Okay? Okay, this is our viewport The center is our viewport Our viewport. And at the if you look on the left panel here, you can see make a shot guys to make sure kan. Nampak kan Keyshot saya ni? Can you see? Boleh Just to make sure Boleh kan?
Boleh.
Just to make sure. Okay, sekarang the left panel is about, okay. Actually, the left panel is basically lah, secara rough saja. Left panel for you assign material environment. The first thing kita learn about material. It's about material. Can you see the tab here? Under sini ada panel, kita ada material, kita ada color, kita ada texture, kita ada environment. We have backplate. Ini the four thing lah. Later on, never mind. Okay, yang penting the first step to the material. The material lah. Material is your left ni, panel ni mainly your material lah. The main thing is material. You just simply drag and drop to your component. You just drag and drop to your component, you will assign material. Okay, if you look Keyshot at the center view ni, kenapa tak? Dia render ni actually, dia depend on your processor guys. Kalau you leave it alone, dia macam gallery. That is kind of real-time rendering. If you leave it longer your ni, you tak internet, dia akan render it gradually. Dia macam real time rendering. Dia akan make much better. You leave it more longer, dia akan render much better. Tapi it consume your memory and your CPU. If you have graphic card GPU, much better. GPU will assist in term of your real time rendering. Okay, this is our ni. Tapi kalau you see Keyshot ni, kalau tengok in our view, dia macam ada shadow, macam dia have a floor. Can you see that? Macam dia ada ground kat sini kan. Okay, for example, exploded view. For exploded view, I don't want to have a ground. Pasal as default, Keyshot they have like a floors and ada ground plane di sini. A ground plane. Pasal ground plane, man, macam kita start, kita lay our product on the ground plane. Tapi macam explore the view, I don't want the ground plane to be there. I can off this ground plane lah. Eh, dia ada default. Eh. To off that ground plane, you can go to environment, nampak ground shadow tu. Ground shadow is off. You mean is this like your component, your product is floating lah, floating. Kishore, they have lighting. They have default lighting already. Eh. Pasal nampak tak? Can you see that anyway? If I rotate my view ni, by left bottom mouse ni, eh, nampak tak that ceiling tu ada kind of illuminate punya contour, nampak tak? Nampak tak guys? Ada macam lighting punya what we call it, dia punya lighting punya based on image. Dia based on standard HDRI, eh, High Dynamic Range Index. Dia ada default lighting, eh. Can you see kan macam ada lighting kata? That's why kita, when you see our product yang at the top surface ni is kind lighter lah, yang at the bottom tu dia become dark, dia tak risau. Pasal dia bottom ni actually not dark, dia lighting by the bottom. Bottom view tu dia tak ada light. Macam dia ada dia at the edge tu dia macam ada grey kan. Dia depend on you punya HDRI punya background. Dia ada the default punya background of your punya ni, eh. Dia punya ni. Dia bukan comes with black lah, no lighting. So the lighting default is there already. Dia punya environment, this is what we call environment lighting. Environment lighting is there. Okay, actually that environment lighting you can change. I show you later. Okay, now okay, you have our product ni, eh, dalam exploded mode. Eh. Okay, this is our viewport lah. Okay, the right panel is about your scene. Eh. Kalau tengok right panel is more on your controlling your scene. Scene, material apa, you boleh check your material scene. Material ni, at the left we assign material. Ini kita boleh look on our library, what material we already assigned to all the component will be listed here, this one. Tapi the main thing from the right panel is about the scene. If you look on the scene here, on the right panel, the scene here, nampak tak? We have exploded view. Can you see nampak tak? Nampak tak? It's a listing macam you're in your slayword. The listing of all your component is there. Nampak tak guys? Class, can you see this one? Exploded view. Hello?
Yeah.
Class. The name exploded you comes from your, dia pasal dia live dengan solid. Nampak tak? This my solid work. You can see my solid work, eh? Solid work. Nampak tak exploded view? You can see kan? Our name of ni exploded view assembly, kan? Exploded view. Then we have all our component, macam I have screw ni. Ini semua library screw I pakai ni. Dan kemudian I have nut, skateboard. All you punya naming of your component, when you export, you punya ni live dengan Kishore will be there. So in your Kishore here, on the right panel, we have this one all about the listing of your component. Under scene, not under material, not under camera. Under tab, make sure you're in the tab scene. If you look, there will be a listing of you punya, all the component of you punya, ni lah. Your software component punya is there. How you name it, your component solid will be there. If I click plus, I have a lot of subcomponent. Now, exploded view is the main thing. That my assembly, skateboard, everything. But if I highlight assembly, cut, ini adalah screw. It will highlight the screw. So, macam I cakap, skateboard. So, nampak dia highlight, can you see the highlight the skateboard, eh? Dia akan highlight the skateboard. All your component name will be, whatever name you name it in your SolidWorks will be same here as the listing in your eShot. So, easy can you to manipulate lah. Mungkin certain object. For example, I want to show, okay, if I click, I can select my component like my skateboard. It's highlight skateboard. I can select my object component like that. Or maybe easiest way, you just select on the screen lah. Make sure your scene is active, eh? If I click object, this one is a skateboard. If I click this one is a wheel. If I click this one is a wheel. For example, you can isolate it. If I want to see the skateboard, yeah, I select the skateboard, I can right click mouse using right button mouse. Eh? Right click mouse, nampak tak dia ada pop-up menu, there will be a pop-up menu. Okay, you want to, actually I want to explain detail, yang penting saja. Eh? Show only, nampak tak? Show only. Not solo mode, eh? Solo mode different. Show only ni mean like we isolate. We want to focus on our skateboard. So tapi actually skateboard ni dia ada dua layer guys. I explain to you later. Okay, kalau you want to show everything. Macam for example, I want to show, okay, this, okay. Skateboard ni we have here ni nama dia hanger guys. The axle ni, we name it hanger. Axle with this one. Okay, I select this hanger. I will show only. So we focus on the, actually, show only. They focus on the hanger. Sometimes easy for us to kita separate component dan kita easily assign material like that lah. Much easy, eh? Much easy. Okay, you want to show all, right click balik, show all, then show all parts. Okay? Okay, yang ini yang tadi, eh, about the scene tu, you punya object listing is there. Object listing is there. Okay, now I want to show you because I just a brief explanation about the shot. I don't want to explain about more detail lah. Just as long as basically you know to use it as to use this software. Alright, okay. Okay, what like I told you, after we import, eh, the first step of doing 3D rendering, we import already import our model. The second step is we assign the material. We send them in. So as I told you, the material is on the left panel. Make sure you intact material, not color. Colors is what basic color. Material is what color. If you look on the material, in Kishore, they have a built-in library material. They have a lot of material. You have architecture material, architecture macam concrete, semua wall, floor, and egg paint, color. Paint is something maybe like you have car punya fairing kan, car body kan dia ada paint star, macam that kind of material. You boleh, you know, you can explore this one. You can explore a lot of material that they built in. Clothes and leather, you have clothes, soft material macam fabric, you can apply. Contour is more like, contour is more like ni, scientific expression, cut way and so on. Tapi banyak material you can tengok. Okay, tapi what we want to focus for our, okay, for example lah, of our skateboard okay. We have to identify which one is plastic, which one is metal. It's about matter of material assigning, assigning material. For example, I want to go for this hanger. Okay, this is my solid work, kan? Oh, this hanger, the axle, hanger in skateboard, hanger means your axle where you mount your tire, your bearing, this one, like kind of axle together. They're special design kind of axle that they have kind of thing. So this part, we have a hole there because in skateboard ini, yang this one, this part is rubber damper. That one is not metal. Rubber damper macam suspension for the skateboard. Skateboard, center skateboard, they don't use spring. They use rubber damper like behave like a suspension for your skateboard. This one also, yang ini, this one also rubber damper. This one also rubber damper. We have three rubber damper. Here rubber damper and also here. This rubber damper here will be mount dekat this lubang lah because based on assembly was mount at this hole. So when they assemble, they ikut dia punya flow, dia flow macam dia akan flow like that, masuk macam tu. So okay, now it's about assigning material. Okay, for example, the hanger is a metal, right? Axle will be metal. So we go for metal. So our left panel, we go for metal. Nampak, we have all the metal up here. You can simply, tapi based on logic metal, takkanlah you use aluminium for ni, and we will of course not use and then dice for. Takkan we'll use gold material. We have gold material for axle. Axle, what material for axle, guys? Axle. Are you listening or not? Can you hear me, guys? Plus? Hello? Hello, class?
Yes.
Hello? Boleh dengar, Can you hear me? Saya pasal ni recording, saya cakap nanti penat nanti kan saya. Kena restart balik. Boleh nampak, Can you hear me? Boleh, Tak ada legion, recording is not, okay, It's running smoothly or not? Okay. Okay, shortcut, for Excel, I just go for, ni lah, metal, not metal polish, polish is for high quality, yang metal yang rough. Orang asyik kita go for metal rough, right? Well, lah, you can explore ni. Takkanlah you go fancy yang ada mesh punya lubang-lubang lonsen lah kan. Takkanlah macam tu kan. Okay, we go for metal. Okay, pasal why? Sometimes certain ni, kita nak, in our finished product in the market, the hanger ni not a plain steel material. They have to paint it. We go for metal to make it more, we can look aesthetically in terms of the color. Is it nice? Pasal kita try to simulate the realistic product. Okay, I go for metal rough. Metal rough, I go for my hanger. Tetapi in solid, sometimes it happen like this. If I want to sign to just this hanger, nampak the whole thing is selected. Nampak tak? If I just simply drag, nampak the whole thing is selected. Be careful, because in solid world, because when I do modeling in solid world, sometimes they are in group. Be careful about this. This happen. Okay, whatever, before I sign the material in Kishore, I select the hanger ni, nampak I select. If kadang you have, kadang sometimes if you are in material punya mode, you want to select, I will select. Make sure you are in scene mode. The left, right panel ni, machine mode that you can select. Select, nampak dia highlight the hanger. To do that, kadang-kadang dia are in group. You want to assign material, everything is selected. So, I want the hanger. So you select the hanger, you right click it, you kena cakap unlink. You always go unlink material, nampak ni. Unlink material, you mean the material is not in group. You mean you separate unlink material. When you apply the link material to all the group, you mean the material is not based on group, okay? Okay, so I unlink. Always check. All these things, all the component you have to, I think you have to manually do it. Macam the wheel ni also, kita check dulu unlink material. Kita tengok mana, macam this rubber ni pun unlink material. But sometimes, dia link together as a group ni material. Macam this one, you right click, unlink material. Macam washer ni, you click, right click, unlink material. Tapi there's a manually done. There's a way to do shortcut, tapi I make it shortcut as ni. Manually, macam this, ni you click, sometimes you have to do this. Unless, because, no, it depends on your project. mine, because my modeling is SOLIDWORKS, I have done something in group. Like yours, maybe if you do your way approach, maybe it's not supposed to be like this. Okay, I will understand. Okay, for example, like this angle, I want to assign again. Rough metal, nampak metal rough, rough metal, red color. Nampak dia tak, the only on the, on the, on the, apa tu? Only on the hanger. Okay, one thing about, the good thing about 3D printed cage, macam sometimes, nampak tak, I have a, this hanger ni, I have a, something like, we call it a deep hole, kan? Deep hole ni where you mount, you punya damper will be mounted. Tetapi deep hole ni macam sharp corner, kan? Dia punya edge is kind of sharp. You can do that. You can make a simulate like it's a chamfer. This is good, macam chamfer ni to present macam dia more certain fillet, macam rounded corner. You can do that. I have select this one. This angle, if you look under scene, make sure you're under scene, make sure you're under properties here. If you look, scroll down, you can go at certain component when you have sharp edges, you can do it. Nampak tak? Can you see that radius here? If I put my radius is one, if I put, you nampak tak dia punya sharp edges to become a little bit rounded? You can do that in Kishon, okay? Dia kadang-kadang certain thing dia tak sharp lah, dia punya edges is tak sharp, rounded edges. So it looks much better lah in terms of rendering. Okay, okay, this for hanger, hanger, okay, for example, okay, okay, what about, okay, hanger, okay, sometimes the bolt, what about the bolt, the bolt is a kingpin, this is a bolt, because actually bolt ni kalau in industry, the bolt ni actually to be black steel lah, metal yang black color, tetapi never mind, I use the same material. Okay, one thing about material, I want to ask you guys, when you have a material ni, nampak, this material already prepared. You now I use the previous I use the library from here lah, metal rough kan. But I can edit this if I select the hanger ni. If I right click and I click edit material, nampak tak ada pop up the first pop up the edit material. I do it again. You play ni, make sure you're in scene. You select ini when you right click ada edit material. The first pop up so edit material. Edit material, okay. Nampak tak you punya right menu here, your right panel to change to material. You can rename your material. Nampak tak? You can rename your material. I want it to be because the name of this component is hanger kan? Red metal hanger. You can name it. You can rename your material. So you got to save it. Bila you save, when you save it, dia akan put dalam library. Which library do you want to put it? Macam dia akan put all in this library. But I want it to be before, okay, before I create, I cancel it again. Because we have our standard library here, right? Okay, this is our material standard library. I can create a new library. Nampak tak? I can create a new library dekat sini, a new folder. I create a new folder. I want to name my skateboard material. I can put it to my own library, skateboard material. That's the name of my folder I want to put my library. Nampak tak? Dia ada skateboard material punya. Like folder is there. Tapi, this tag is already, we put a folder here. Okay, okay, I select this hanger. Okay, I create already create the folder. Okay, make sure I'm in scene. Kalau you scene, you tak berselect. Scene, okay, I select it. Hold on here. Okay, pasal the Webex pop up ni, the block mining. Okay, make sure I'm in scene, I select this hanger, I edit the material. Okay, this one I already rename tadi, red metal hanger. Then I save it. When I save it, you put into your necessary folder lah, skateboard material. You can see the skateboard material there, I click there. So in my skateboard material, there are add one of my custom library file. You can use this. It means you don't have to use standard library lah. You can use your body. Okay, that is skateboard hanger. Okay, what about apa yang lagi kita nak paint yang we have red metal? This for aesthetic guys. Bukan semua metal. They can paint. In the marketing finished product, they market, they will paint our metal. Maybe the board ni memang kita use the industrial lah. That's right, industrial board. Walaupun it is inside, never mind. Let's say the board also. Make sure I in scene mode. Okay, I select the board. Okay, I can use the same apply to the board pun boleh. Okay, nampak? If I want to apply to the board, nampak tak? Dia, this sometimes you have this problem. Pasal in SOLIDWORKS, I make it in group. So I select this board, I unlink material. So I simply drag, so you will be only the board will be assigned. Okay, okay. They use the same material. Just click okay. Okay. What else I need to be? Okay, we have a board. Then this one is as I told you, example. What about the nut? The nut. Can you see there is a nut here? The nut here. Hold on, my control to select more than one. The nut. Class, boleh buat? I explain that. Is okay? Boleh. Class. Hello, class. Is it okay?
Boleh.
Okay. I hope nanti you play back lah recording, nanti you can pause, rewind balik. Okay, now I can select more than one. Hold on your control, select more than one. Okay, make sure that you right click also, unlink juga. Just be careful, just in case, because sometimes it's unlink material. Ada dia unlink material. Okay, if I drag, I select more than one. Actually, you can. Okay, I can do it like this. Okay, another way, instead of drag and drop, you can do it. I right click, this one material is red. You can copy. That's apa, when I select this nut, copy material. You can see that it's copy material, and I select this nut. I select this nut, I select that nut, right click of it, paste material, the second one, paste material. So that's one way, one shot to apply to it. So I have another nut also I got to paint in terms of aesthetic, and they will paint juga. Walaupun your nut to steel color, default is a black color, right? So I can okay, make sure I see mode, I select all this, select all the bolt and the screw, the bolt and use paste material, so I don't have to drag again and again. Sometimes they will pin, you pin in terms of the finished product, they will pin with me. Actually, the bolt there actually is going to be black metal, and never mind, I do it like that. Okay, also, when we have the bolt concealed dengan damper, then we have washer, and this one, the nut also, I pin the paste material. Okay, let's go for our hanger. And let's go for our hanger, then, okay, what about the base plate, okay? Okay, base plate ni. Okay, ni dia base plate. The base plate will be mount lah, pasal dia akan screw, dia akan mount to the bottom of your skateboard. Ada lubang, there's a holes here. There's a base plate akan mount kat sini, and the conceal they will lock by nut and the upper screw there lah. Upper screw there. So the base plate also the same material. The base plate also paste material. I don't have to get just paste material. Okay, the base plate ni. Alright. Okay, do we need a rounded corner like I do for hanger? I don't think so. Pasal I already do fillet and solid work already. This one no need to rounded. Because you can go base plate when you select, you can go for the property, you can make it round corner. I don't think so lah. Tapi ini tak perlu ni lah pasal dia inside lah bila example. Okay, let me save dulu. Okay, let me save my work first. Better you save. Ada dua, you save package or you save. Save package like you save in solid work like pack and go. Tapi in this case, I just save dulu lah. Save basically, you just save and you need to save to your folder. Let me create one of my folder. Hold on. Skateboard 2, yes, name is skateboard. Dia say MPIP file, this T-shirt file. Right, okay, we have done yang ni, dia punya tu. Okay, okay, another thing is kita punya, apa tu, the... Okay, what about the washer? What is washer? Washer is before, nampak tak? Kita ada thread ni kan, thread dia akan lock dengan, we have nut here. And when you mount, we assemble it, we have nut. The thread tu akan lock dengan nut. So we have, actually we have washer. Washer, okay, we go for metal . Metal, we go for metal. Actually, washer bukan washer tu will be hidden. You can make it same color if you want to. Tapi biasanya washer is standard part. We can go for what we call it metal rough tadi. You know, you depend how you have a lot of every chrome. For washer, actually, it's kind like steel material. It's a steel. Where is steel? We go for. We have steel here. We have steel. Nampak tak? Steel. Stainless steel. Tapi stainless is red. We have radial brush, stainless steel rough, we can do this for washer. Nampak tak? Be careful lah, nampak? I can see that. They happen like this. They can go for, be careful before you drag. Sometimes in your solid work, you have to unlink the material. Unlink the material. Also, this one, I select unlink the material. I want to focus individually on the. So, where is it? Steel, mana tadi? Steel rough, steel metal, steel rough. Okay, I hope you tak send. Dia tak sign yang lain. Tak apalah, kalau dia tak sign nanti kita boleh unlink kemudian. So, okay, never mind. Okay, also, I can copy this material. I can do this also. Copy, select this one. Copy material. You can select that also. You can paste it. You can paste the material that is for washer. So, what about bearing? Bearing apa? Bearing is more like chrome, right? Stainless, kan? Stainless steel, kan? Stainless steel. No, brush ni dia ada brush. Dia macam ada bump mapping brush. Dia macam dia ada kind of scratch brush ni. Ada material like stainless steel, rough stainless steel, we go for stainless steel. Okay, let's say kita go for stainless steel we go for, where is it? Stainless steel. Typical stainless steel for, mana dia tadi? Steel brush. Yeah, let's go dekat Perdana Mesti lah. Mesti lah. Dia smooth lah. Stainless steel yang kadang kita kena browse dulu yang juga silver tak boleh. Mana stainless steel? Steel yang polish, go polish. That will be your, okay, this will be your bearing. Okay, yang ini already assigned lah. Yeah. Okay, this one also, mana tadi steel, polish, it's time for bearing. Tapi eh, sekarang, this one, this bearing ni, I use library from internet eh, tapi the ball is not, it's not together kan eh. Be careful that steel apply to the ball also lah. That is bearing. Okay, this kind of like you have to deal lah eh. Do things like this lah eh. Okay. Then another thing, yang nut tadi eh. The nut tadi red color kan eh. Okay, I can simply, I can use the library tadi eh. Macam the library tadi, skateboard material library. Skateboard material macam the library, I can supply to the nut. Tapi okay, okay, nampak dia assign. So certain part tu, the nut ni eh, it means I have to unlink material. Be careful about it. Take note about this unlink material. So dia tak, ni kadang happen. Not always. Sometimes happen kalau in your solid work. Like mine ni, it happen to be like this. Because dia sometimes is consider, they put it in what group. Macam nak, be careful. If I slide, I nampak dia tu. So I got to select this thing. If that happen, you unlink this material. And you can do that. Okay, yang tadi, okay, one thing, good thing, kalau you put into library tadi, macam saya punya washer ni kan, eh, I edit the material, I name it washer kan, pun boleh, you just put into library, one way to handle it, you save it, where you want to save in skateboard material, so your skateboard material, you have to washer, washer, I can drag, I can use the library like this, I can simply drag like that, on washer, tapi be careful nampak tak, dia ada, be careful, if you nampak, if select the washer, make sure you're in scene mode, select the washer, unlink material. Ini kind of tedious that it happen lah kalau benda macam ni. Actually, not every time will be. It depends on how you group in your solid work. But before, when you model the solid work, you punya solid work, you can ni lah. Okay, macam ni we have, tadi you can edit this material. I cakap this material name bearings. Okay, B-A-R-I-N, bearings. Save it into my skateboard folder. Bearing is there. Alright, okay, then I can simply drag the bearing from here to this one. Yes, kemudian, okay, kadang certain view, macam ini nampak, this view kacau kan, you cannot assign, you can select this object, make sure you're in scene mode, kalau material tak ada, scene mode, you select this object, you right click, hide part, you hide certain component that you select, hide, so dia hide certain temporary. So you can focus on this thing. Okay, the ball bearing is the assigned. Okay, the ball bearing also assigned. Okay, the washer. Okay, washer, drag to washer. Okay, washer is there. Right. Okay, okay, I have done this. Boleh eh, kelas? Okay, macam ni kerja dia. Boleh tak? Boleh buat tak? Boleh eh? Alright, understand? Hello class,
yes,
are you
yes.
Listening? Boleh. Boleh. So macam ni lah, I hope you listen. Okay, nampak tak? Yang ni nampak, saya dah ada jadi washer. Ini salah ni, ini is temper eh. Saya unlink material. It's okay, memang unlink. Okay, material like this one eh. Okay, yang ini also washer eh. Ini washer. Ini also washer, I unlink material. Okay, select washer. This one washer, yes. Okay, this one. Ini, this three is damper, rubber damper. So where is rubber damper? Rubber damper is here eh. You look on material, under material, that is called rubber. Mana? Rubber is supposed to be there. Rubber. Okay, kalau tak ada rubber, it's supposed to be there. Something I've done, because I've done system setting. Ada, it's supposed to be there, rubber material. Atau you boleh download from internet, nanti I show you if I have time. Kita boleh guna cloud library. If you click at cloud library, you open the keyshop in the library, you can download a lot of custom made, eh? More fancy material, you can download it and you can drag it in. You can, they will install in your library. They will call rubber. Kalau tak, you type, nampak sini, there is a search button, you type in rubber. Nampak tak rubber? Green. Kan? Class. Green. Eh? Green. Hello class. Nampak eh? Rubber. Okay, actually rubber green ni, this one I make it, I already edit it. Okay. At default, bila your case, you punya rubber is black color, guys. Yeah? Black color. Okay, actually green is already edit to become green. Okay, I want to show how you can edit the material to become. I use the black rubber first. Okay, I select, you know, nampak, eh? This one. This is a rubber material. Let's focus on it. This one also. Okay, this one I can, later I can paste on this and damper it. Okay, this rubber, can you see? This is your rubber. Okay, one thing, this is a rubber damper. You look at this rubber damper, macam they have sharp edges. You can do that under scene. You can you scroll down, make sure you punya tab under properties here. You can go there, you go for radius 1, nampak lah, the radius 1, not too big lah, 0.5 lah, go for 1. Dia nampak more rounded. Can you, nampak tak dia rounded? Can you see that dia nampak rounded sikit, nampak lah, and nampak sikit, interesting lah. Eh, this rubber. Okay, one thing I want to edit this. This is a black rubber. How do we edit? I change the color. How do I change the color? Right, you can see my hear my voice, just to make sure because we are recording this thing. I don't want to kena repeat balik nanti susah. Can you hear my voice? Semua is okay, semua run smoothly, eh?
Okay.
Lee Jong, are you recording, right?
Yeah.
Right, okay, good. Okay, I want to edit. It's a black rubber. Edit material. Edit material. Okay, nampak? Rubber. You can name it. I want it to be green rubber. You can name it. Rubber. Okay, I want to change. How do we change the color? The color ni, kalau dah you play around dengan graphic in software like this, only the diffuse. Diffuse is your main color. Do not change the specular. Diffuse mean you punya main color. The diffuse. Because the diffuse, nampak tak? We under diffuse. Diffuse, it means the main color of your object. Change the diffuse. Ah, ni like typical graphic lah. You play around dengan color lah. You can go for R, G and D lah. You can control it. Make sure you can use candle ni. Boleh pakai dia punya ni. Biasa rubber ni, kau main like yellow sikit lah. You want to make kind of like this. This ini translucent guys, eh. Ini is not simply rubber guys, eh. Kalau you, the more you leave it alone, you punya computer, when you render final, it's kind like translucent. Memang like a real rubber punya bit. Macam ni kan lah translucent sikit. Macam the light pass through little bit. Translucent, we call translucent, eh. So it looks nice kalau you, you make a final render of it. Okay, I think I want to change little bit like this. More like yellowish sikit, eh. I edit material again. I want to make it a little bit more yellowish sikit, more stand out. Okay, never mind. This rubber. Okay, so I have this one. Okay, I save it. Green rubber, get into your scaleboard material. Ini I override it. See, it's already there. So I can simply drag it here. No, drag it there. Drag it there. Ini pun I want to make. You select this. Make sure, kalau you susah select, make sure you under scene. You punya tab ni under scene. You select this thing. Okay, you pergi under properties. You can make it rounded corner. Little bit. Not too much. I don't put too big lah. About 1 millimeter. Make it little bit rounded. You punya, sometimes you punya object sharp corner also. Okay, I can drag it also. Yes. Dan kemudian make it, this one, I select this one, make it also rounded corner one. So, they kind of rounded. Okay, that's our damper. Alright. Sorry lah, panjang guys, eh. Boleh, eh. Boleh buat, eh. Panjang pasal banyak komponen ni. Sepatutnya I show you simple-simple punya produk, eh. Tapi yours is simple lah, you punya tak detail, eh. Okay, this one because mine is, I already chose as a skateboard. At least you get the picture, eh? You get the picture. Okay, what about the wheels, guys? Wheels ni lah. Wheels. Guys, wheel ni material apa? Come on, class. Come on, participate lah. I don't want, I'm the only one who the talking. I want you guys to participate also, eh? Biarlah as, active sikit ni, participate, eh? Nak saya cakap ni, cepat sikit. Wheel material apa? Skateboard wheels? Class, are you listening?
Rubber.
Takkan lah, wheel rubber. Come on, eh? Wheel the hard material, plastic lah. Be careful guys. Okay, kita go. Can you see my browser?
Silicon?
Silicon, no. Silicon is soft. Wheel for skateboard. Longboard, apa ni? Skateboard, skateboard. 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 Wheel. Can you see my browser, nampak eh?
Yes.
Material, apa dia cakap? Skateboard wheel material is made of polyurethane. Ada tak dalam solid? Dalam ni ada polyurethane ke? Kita tengok. Polyu. Apa tak apa? Urethane tak ada. Tak, actually kalau you use then nampak sini. I tak ada explain. I don't have time to explain. Cloud Library, you click at Cloud Library. You kena register juga. You have to register. Dia ada, dia buka. Dia ada. They have more more complete. Complete. Polyurethane semua cakap ada. Tapi dia ni because this one standard level. Tapi never mind. Actually, kalau if you skateboard ni, kalau skateboard ni, skateboard ni, kalau image yang material kind of hard plastic. Nampak tak guys? Hard plastic. Nampak tak? Macam this one. Can you see it's a hard plastic? It's a hard plastic. Can you see this one? It's a hard plastic tapi shiny. Ini daripada Shopee. Nampak? Plus. You boleh buy accessory, eh. Kalau you ada skateboard, boleh buy accessory ni. Tukar wheels ni. Hard shiny plastic. Betul lah guys. Hello, plus. Eh? Hard shiny plastic. Alright? Boleh nampak ni kan? Alright, okay. So we go for yang ni, kita okay. Material yang ni, kita make our own material. So we go for plastic material. We go for plastic. Okay, we have plastik, nampak plastik. Jadi, how about takkanlah clear, takkanlah transparent plastik. Mengaruh orang kan? Tak boleh. So, we have hard shiny plastik. Nampak ni hard shiny plastik warna red. Dia kena mask kan? You, the way I choose the color, my hanger, my base plate, even metal, it paint ni red metal. You have to choose, pasal this in term of aesthetic lah. Pasal you want to show you punya product to your client. Kadang-kadang you can do alteration. Takkanlah the color is also, apa color yang match dengan red ni? What color will match? In term of aesthetic. Come on guys, cepat sikit. Is it blue plastic?
Yeah.
Color yang match. Kita nak sell our product, eh? Kita want to promote our product. We want to show our client kadang. Okay, macam ni ke? Match ke? Blue shiny plastic?
Black okay. Color.
Black color. Black.
Putih.
Black. Oh, korang ni pun ada artistic value juga, eh? Pandai juga, eh? Black match, eh? Black match to everything, kan? Tapi kita more like ni lah. I go for red dengan red. Okay, let's say for example, this is a quick one for this video, eh. So you have to, my point is you can match the color tu. You can show to your client, sometimes they are not satisfied with the color, you change lah, gitu je. Okay, I go for red plastic. Nampak hard shiny, kan you see ni? Hard shiny plastic. Guys, nampak lah, eh? Boleh? Right? Okay? Jangan letak fancy, ya. Jangan, do not fancy. Ini, this red, this one, so pure green, dark green, tak. Make sure that it match lah, eh. Okay. Okay, this one kenapa we don't have waste ni? Because I tak show everything, eh. Show all, eh. So my another wheel, oh no, sorry, show all part. So my wheel is there. Okay, I have this plastic. You can right click, edit material. You can name it wheel red plastic. You can rename it. You can do sub button to change the color. You can name it. You save this on my skateboard wheel red plastic. So in my skateboard is there. My skateboard punya material under skateboard, mana skateboard folder here, skateboard material plastic is there. So I simply drag to here. Okay, I can drag to there. Okay, yang ni, ini pun you can make, eh. You select, if I select ini, dia macam sharp corner kan, sharp corner little bit. Ini untuk visualize is good juga lah. It's good. You select this one. I select, make sure you have in scene mode, you select ni, dia highlight the wheel. So you scroll down, make it something like the around the corner little bit. Not too much about 1 mm. So ini nampak tak? You punya ada, nampak kan you see the ni? The kind of around the corner. Semua is more interesting. It also goes, same goes for here. Make it. Okay, dia macam dah ni kan. Dia udah ikut tadi kan. I think it's under one group. Okay, let me save dulu before mana tahu crash ke apa ke. Alright, okay. Boleh, eh? Boleh buat lagi guys, eh. Okay, we have a problem. Nampak tak? Yang ni semua dah jadi silver material. Tak apa, it's okay, never mind. So ini kita unlink all the part lah, unlink all the, as I told you, unlink the material. Ini happen, not to you guys. I don't think so you will feel this. Mine pasal I, the way I model it, I dah already subgroup, eh? Because dia, T-shirt dia will identify different component. Not shouldn't be any problem. Ini also I will unlink the material. Yeah, you will not face this kind of tedious work. Okay, also the bolt ni unlink material. Sorry, I have to do this, yeah. Unlink material. Unlink material. Itu dah, make sure bila you solid work tu. Jangan, sometimes you are in group tau, eh. I make it into group. Unlink material. Tak apa, it's okay. Kita boleh check. Kalau kita tengok direct material. Okay, ni same goes tadi. Mas tadi base plate. Go for base plate. Okay, good. Then where is our wheel? Wheel go for wheel. Apa? The wheel apa tak? Is the, be careful. The wheel, before I drag it. The wheel, select it. Unlink material. Unlink material. Okay, if I drag to the wheel, okay, good. Wheel is there. And already. Okay, whatever setting round kena is set, eh, pasal you punya dia dah set, eh. Wheel is there. Right, then our hand. Okay, sekarang ni our nampak ni, kita punya this one. This one. This one. Kalau ini kalau you drop, dia tak boleh, eh. Macam ni, you macam ni, make sure you select one ni. Eh. You copy this one, copy material, then you select all the nuts. The nuts. You have to do it like this. And the nuts here, you. Ah, ni kalau more than one. Paste material. The second one, paste material, so you will paste. Sometimes they will paint, before they market the product, they will paint it. They will paint to look nice. They paint the nut. Even the nut ni at default, likely is not, they will paint. They will spray it. Okay, and also goes for this one. The screw, dia akan kunci lock with the nuts. So if I base, be careful, dia tak effect semua. Kalau tak pun, you be careful. Unlink material, handling material. Handling material, handling material, handling material. Okay, you can select control, select base material. Because I already copy the metal, yang base plate, the red metal. Okay, sometimes okay, okay, that is hidden part here, right? Again, ada hidden part. Okay, ini also base plate, base on the hanger pun also. Okay, and also red metal. Okay, sometimes kita nak macam mana I want to send material, everything is intact here in position is what. Okay, you can simply select the object here, hide the component, hide part, select this one, hide part. I think the bearing already here pasal dia ada group dengan tadi. Yang ini nut also ni, ni the nut ni, we have a nut ni, make sure you unlink material kalau you have when you drag the assign semua, nut. Yes. Okay, what about the, okay, I hide the knife, I hide part. Okay, washer is there. Okay, tak apa lah benda ni, I don't want to be detailed. Oh, I think it's okay, bearing is there. Bearing, I think, pasal dia group tadi. Okay, the one is another nut. Okay, the nut ini also. Make sure I select this one. Unlink material. Then I will track this. Okay, then you have one of this. Okay. Okay, I think that's okay. The only thing sekarang ni kita hide the base plate. I want to assign the rubber material. Okay, the kingpin also must be unlink material. Actually, the kingpin is hidden, guys. Supposed to be black. Tak apalah, it's okay lah. I make it red color also. And also for the ni, we lock dengan nut ni. Unlink material first. You don't have to do this unlink material. Mine is special case. Mine is special case. You don't have to actually. Right. Okay, the only thing yang is a rubber damper lah. Rubber damper nampak green. Sign ya. Nampak tak? Dia sometimes the effect. Be careful lah. Tu. Kalau you have this problem like mine, you kena unlink dulu. Before you drag and drop. Ni is also damper. Unlink material. Okay. Unlink material. Okay, then you can simply drag and drop this one. This one, this is glass and this one. Ni skateboard dia ada damper kan? Dia ada damper. Satu when you press punya foot on the skateboard, satu damper on the hanger and the axle, satu damper on the side tu yang dia mount dekat itu. Dia mount dekat itu. Dia ada both side. Dia ada two side. Satu damper here, satu damper on here. You punya impact how you press the board. Rubber damper. Dia fikir kalau itu suspension. So you, when you ride the skateboard, dia smooth lah. Dia suspension dulu. Dia tak keras lah. Dia soft. Alright, I think I save dulu. Okay, I save dulu. Boleh buat lagi ya? Boleh ya? Sikit je lagi. Sabar sikit. Boleh ya? Hello class, are you listening or not?
Boleh.
Okay, show all part. Show all part semua ada. Beautiful nampak eh. This kind of thing present. Tapi okay, ni nampak tak? Saya punya wooden board. This supposed to be wood kan? The skateboard. Let me save dulu. My wooden board is supposed to be ini. Pasal tadi kan, I got problem. Dia S1 group. Okay, never mind. It's okay. I select the board ni. Make sure you're in sync. Kerana you any material punya tab ya. You tak boleh select. Make sure in sync. You select the wooden board. The wooden board ni, I select ni. I want to show guys. I isolate. If I isolate mean you apa show only show only. Nampak tak? Saya punya wooden board ni macam hollow kan? Dia punya top surface tu because already separated. Why is it separated? Because okay, I want to show guys in solid wood. Can you see guys? This can you see my solid wood guys? Nampak eh?
Can.
Solid wood. I already assign colour. Sebab apa? Ada reason to do. Nampak tak? You know you do you know how to? It's good like this. Katakanlah you punya project is skateboard. Maybe certain top because the skateboard, dia punya board tu, dia punya top surface ni normally finished product dia akan, macam mana cakap ni, the top surface ni dia akan put a layer tau. Actually the base is a wooden material but the top dia tu dia akan macam like a sticker, a layer, macam ada layer of material, special plastic material and they put a logo abstract image. I'll show you later tu. That's why in solid wood I make a different color because when you export to T-shirt will reveal as different. Kalau you tak put different color, maybe a certain faces we can send. How do we send color in solid wood? Tahu kan? Send color, tahu kan material kan? Select one face, for example, I select the face. Macam ni, so, macam dia select, I select face. you boleh select face ni macam ni supposed to be okay, kenapa dia select voting. You boleh select face tapi macam you boleh change color, you can check. You boleh change color solid work, you boleh play around dengan material. Actually dia boleh, kenapa saya tak boleh pula ni. Okay, you can change the color in your solid work. Yeah? Okay, I want to save time, boleh. Bila you export to screenshot, so they will separate it. Nampak tak? My upper layer tu dia separate it. This good, pasal only the base here is the wooden material. Okay, ni I already isolate the wooden skateboard, not the base. So I want it to make it wood. Okay, wood, we can go for wood. Where is wood? Wood, you go for back to the library here. You can see my t-shirt, eh? Boleh, eh? Guys, you can see my t-shirt, eh? Okay, alright. Sekarang ni the wood, eh? You go for wood. Where is wood? Wood is there. The wood, nampak? Wood. Okay, you have ash wood, you have wood. Tapi yang logic lah. Biasanya kalau macam this kind of wood for, maybe it's a maple lah. Maple wood. Or maybe maple wood rough, maple wood satin. Depend, eh? I want to use, okay, pine wood. It depends how you punya ni. Okay, if I want to go to, actually guys, I don't have time. If you click at the club library, I don't to show you, I don't have time. Dia akan buka browser, open your browser, you register dulu, dia akan all the keyshot punya, all the library, fully loaded punya library. Complete library, a lot type of wood you can download. Bila you, then you can download from that, then it will be put into your material library in your keyshot. Understand, eh? So I don't have time to explain. You just click club library, dia open to the screen. Okay, if I want to use, for example, maple wood, eh? Maple wood rough, eh? Maple wood rough, I just simply drag to here, show you maple wood rough. So we have a wood material there. Kalau if you, boleh nampak kat sini guys, wood material. Guys, hello. Hello class.
Yes, doctor.
Ah, nampak tak? Dah nampak, can you see? Can you focus? Okay, can you leave it? I believe you learn for a while. Nampak tak? Can you see the wood grain? Nampak tak? Wood grain. Ada tak?
Ada.
Ah, wood grain ni biasa kalau for like, based on the raw material, the furniture manufacturer, the manufacturer lah, macam even like furniture wood material kan, the raw material they get from the pembalakan lah kan, the wood depend macam, tapi the wood grain I think it's not right, eh, the wood grain ni pasal wood grain, pasal wood ni naturally dia ada wood grain kan, tapi the orientation of this wood grain is something not right. I want to be the wood grain to be more flow like this, longitudinal lah, in terms of radial like this. Okay, to do that, okay, I want to show you one more thing. Okay, if I select this material, okay, make sure since I select this one, I want to edit the material, okay. I can name it this, you can name skateboard wood, eh? Skateboard wood, okay, I name it, okay. Okay, now I want to do, okay, before I save it, I want to, you can see that the material here, beside you can change color, okay, I don't want to change, because we already have texture wood this color. What I want to change in term of the grain of the wood texture tu, eh? The texture, nampak tak? That's a type texture ni, not properties, texture. You can, okay, you can move, pasal dia, this wood grain material, they have macam procedural, eh? Macam mathematical punya procedure already there. They will render based on the material procedure. I can control the orientation of the wood grain, eh? To do that, to control the orientation, there's a lot of things. I don't have time to explore what everything, but just basic saja. I explain to you guys, you can do it by moving the texture. Remember, the texture is your mapping coordinate. When I put, whatever you punya, because kita play around dengan texture tau, the wood grain texture, dia project. Dia project to your bottom ni, your punya surface to project like in Z direction, the wood grain. I don't want it to be project like that. I can move the texture like this. When I move the texture, okay, let me scroll. I can rotate it in term of, kalau if you look, you nampak tak, there is a tripod. Axis tripod to control the rotation of my grain. If I click move texture, if I click no, dia tak ada. Move texture there. Okay, I hope you're recording this, eh? Take note about this. Okay, I can move. Okay, I want to change the texture of the, let me move it. Pasal kita ada X, Y and Z, eh? Let me control, let me check dulu. Let me go for green. If the green, nampak tak ada highlight green. If I move it, it doesn't affect. It's still on the radial, kan? So I reset balik, eh? No, not green. So make sure I click and move. If I move on the, okay, the red color is, I think is X axis. Nampak tak the texture dia lain? Nampak tak the texture lain? Nampak tak? They not become radial. Can you see that? Nampak tak? Eh? If I, they become, okay, I want to rotate it 90 degree. To do rotate 90 degree, you hold on your shift. Pasal it shift ni, press your shift, dia increment 15 degrees. I want to hold on to make sure that, okay, kalau you tak sure, you cancel balik, eh. Okay, macam ni. You reset balik. You move texture. Okay, this is a good view. Okay, sekarang ni, if I want player one to, I rate on to, so I make sure that I hold on my shift. So it means that ni dia, okay, dia tak 90 degree lagi. Okay, this is 90 degree. So when I click okay, if you look on the texture, no, it's still not this one. I reset it. Not the X axis. Sorry, I do it again. Not the red color. It's the blue color. Sorry guys, the blue color. If I rotate it. Yes, the blue color. If I rotate to 90 degree like this, nampak tak? The wood texture tu dah become orange texture. It's no longer radial. Nampak tak? Can you see guys? Nampak? Eh? You can play around lah. Depend lah kalau if you have wood material, kalau you tak ada, it's okay. To me, I have a wood material in my case. Tapi the need is not right lah pasal dia. You can move texture again. Now I go for translation. Nampak tak? That is a cursor ini. If you off the translate, translate is not. Make sure translate is on. I can position. I mean, I want the texture to be more. Orientation is like that. Kadang wood texture ni kadang daripada raw material from the wood, dia punya texture the grain is like this instead of radial. Nampak tak? Can you see kan? Nampak eh? Boleh? Right? Okay class, are you listening or not? Okay, show everything, show all part. Okay, that's there. Okay, now I want to, okay, I save dulu my part. Ya, yeah, save dulu. Okay. This is not right lah. Takkanlah solid red color pula dia punya top layer kan. Now I want to do graphic. Eh, I want to do graphic because we have a layer be layering on the wood ni. We want to do graphic. Okay, I select this one. Make sure I'm in scene mode. I select this one. Okay, make sure I save dulu. Save dulu. Okay, I'm in scene mode. Okay, sekarang ni I select. Make sure I select the top layer only. I isolate it. Eh, you go dulu. You show only. Pasal you not save memory and yang you don't want to the other component to disturb you. You want to focus on it. Okay, this one I want to go for on put some like an abstract image. I have an abstract image in you can download from the internet guys. If you look, you can see the browser. Yeah, you check out abstract. You just type as you can download any lot of abstract texture. Abstract texture you look from. Banyak ya, yeah, you boleh nak. Make sure you check the high quality. Macam ni lah contoh guys, eh. Hey, hello class. Hello, can you see this one?
Yes.
Ini your creativity guys, eh. Okay, I already have mine. Make sure jangan yang, jangan. Try to get the high resolution lah. You know lah, high resolution lah. Macam pixel yang not low resolution lah. Yang very high resolution juga. High resolution detection. Okay, I don't want to explain more. You can download mana-mana abstract image that interest you. So I have mine is, hold on. Mine is this one, can you see ini? Nampak? Jadi. Okay. Boleh nampak ni? Texture.
Boleh.
Alright, okay, this one, okay. I want to do this texture, I want to put it, in the keyshot. Okay, how do we do this? Okay, sekarang I select this one. Make sure you select the top layer of your skateboard. Eh? Okay, I edit the material. Eh? Don't forget. Then sekarang we back ni, the pop-up ni, the blocking my keyboard to my menu atas yang hollow. Sekejap, tunggu dia drag balik ke atas. Hollow. Okay, I select this one. Kacau daun betul lah benda ni. Hold on, eh. Okay, sorry. Okay, edit material. Eh? This one, edit material, you can name in. Okay, you nampak tak? Okay, before that, sorry guys, before this material, before I edit material, because I have not assigned material to here again, the top layer, and I have not assigned any material. Okay, I got to assign. What material will be the top layer? Will it be plastic? Plastik kan? Betul kan? Plastik lah. Let's say kita go shiny plastik. Okay, never mind. Okay, let's say go kita, never mind. You go for, it's actually, I go for a hard, shiny red plastic. Never mind. It's kind of shiny. It's kind of shiny. Okay, now I using shiny red plastic. Actually, I don't want to use red color. I can replace it by texture that I chose this now. Okay, then now I select this object. I select this one. I edit the material. Kacau lagi pop-up. Hold on. Okay, right. Edit the material. Okay, I name it. Apa tadi? Kita have to be specific. Better you name your material, guys. Eh? Macam you punya top layer. Okay, skateboard. Top layer. Actually, it's not red, guys. Right? Nama ni bukan red, eh. Top layer. Okay, now. Okay, let me save dulu. Under skateboard material. Okay, just go. Okay, sekarang ni. Okay, this is my skateboard material. Okay, nampak? Skateboard top layer. Nampak tak here under texture, eh? Macam tadi, texture. skateboard ni, texture, texture where you can put any bitmap image you download from the internet lah. Macam tadi I download yang the abstract, the abstract that I show, so okay that one. Okay, so okay, how we put the texture? Okay, under texture ni nampak tak? You have all this bob. You don't play with spatula, do not play with bump. Pasal ni is kalau if I tissue heavy, memang I will explain. Tapi this is basic. Just play around dengan diffuse. Diffuse is the main texture. Diffuse. You, I click at the diffuse here. You can replace that diffuse. Okay, if I click at the box here, if I click at the checkbox ni, diffuse. Okay, they ask you for texture. You mean you want to replay because why? Our basic diffuse is a red color, right? If I click at checkbox here, they ask you for texture you want to replace. Nampak tak? Can you see the folder ni? The abstract ni, the abstract that I chose ni. I click okay, then you have texture will be there. Nampak tak? Nampak kan? Yeah. So kita adakan ini untuk kita aesthetic value of our product lah. We can show some graphic, maybe we can show to our client. Okay, we can discuss with our client, okay, how you like, we want to do. We can, ni lah, a lot of kita can do some variation, design variation. Okay, this example. So make sure you get the high resolution. Okay, the base material is shiny. Remember that before that I already apply hard shiny plastic. So it means a kind of shiny. Tapi it's still shiny plastic. Nampak tak? Nampak? Dia ada kind ada shiny. Can you see that? Based on lighting. Dia kind ada shiny. Nampak tak? Ada shiny. Yeah? Shiny. Tetapi the texture is no longer red because the diffuse have been replaced by texture. Okay? Okay, another thing. Kalau I show all, still, okay, I have my product like this. Tetapi something is lag. Kita tak ada logo, right? Betul tak guys? Kita tak ada logo. Nampak kan? You need have to put some like abstract. Biasalah skateboard kan, you have to put some moto, some other apa tu, what we call it? Any logo lah, any image abstract. Okay, to be layered on here, the logo. How do you put logo? Okay, let me isolate it to the top layer. I show only. Okay. I can add logo, okay, under this material, skateboard top layer ni, okay, I can add some abstract image or logo, you have a logo, you can download that from internet, banyak lah, you can, adalah logo, apa-apa, abstract logo, boleh logo, so tapi syaratnya, macam you can put your logo, you can create, macam if you are familiar with software like Illustrator, and maybe Photoshop, I think Matrix Illustrator create logo, abstract, apa, typo, you can make your own punya, apa, your logo of your company and so on. Okay, I already logo, tapi syarat dia guys, must make it PNG. You know what is PNG? That is different between JPEG image and PNG. PNG, it mean your white background will become transparent. Will become transparent. So, I already have mine. I don't have to explain. Okay, maybe you can create your own logo. Okay, I have already my logo here. Okay, well, how do we add logo, on top of this texture, okay, under this top layer, okay, under this, just now we go for texture, right? Can you see the menu, right? Nampak, guys? Nampak tak sini labels? Hello, class.
Nampak.
Are you listening?
Yeah.
Label. You create a labels here. Okay, under label. This label ni, you are layering a logo here. You add logo. Nampak tak? Under label, you have here slot. Okay, you click at the positive arrow. You add label. I add texture, not video. Even you can add video when macam you can show animation ada macam TV screen, LED screen. The screen you want to show other movie. Boleh, you can do that. Ada when you do animation, not still image. Okay, this one I add level texture. So they ask for where I have already. If you look, mine is yang ini. I have this one. Can you see ni? Boleh nampak ni? Logo.
Boleh nampak.
Kenapa? Nampak. Ni logo I download from internet ni. Ni tapi PNG. This is PNG. Kalau you JPEG, you kena have to use Photoshop all the white background because sometimes kalau JPEG, the white background is not transparent. When you open in Photoshop, you boleh crop. You know how to do that in Photoshop. Kalau you biasa dengan grafik, you can crop it. Wizard one, guna Photoshop tu, you can remove the white, become it clean. Save it as PNG. I mean the background color. This one I already make in PNG. This one actually the background is not white, it's transparent. Okay, for that. Okay, now. Alright, so I select this logo. So it will be. Can you see my T-shirt? Nampak, class. I'm not in T-shirt. Can you see the T-shirt?
Nampak.
Okay. Alright, so we have a logo. Nampak tak? The logo ni we can scale it up. We can scale. Nampak tak? You have ini, you can scale. Okay, maybe little bit. Not too big lah. Sometimes it depends how resolution you download from the internet lah. Download from internet, you can put any kind of logo there. You can drag it like that. You can position it. Nampak tak? Make sure you kalau my translate is off. Kalau my translate is on, nampak? Saya akan arrow, nampak kan? Position like that. Tapi nampak kan? The rotation is on the other side. So I need to rotate it. Nampak tak? I need to rotate it 90 degrees. I don't have to use this tripod. Don't have to use. To rotate it, you can use under here. Under label here, you scroll at the bottom here, the under angle. Nampak tak? Angle 90 degrees. You mean your texture of your logo will be bound as 90 degree. I make it inverse 90 degree. Negative 90, so it go to inverse direction. Buat tak guys? Buat tak? Ada logo. Kalau too big, you small lah. Make it a little bit small. You can position it where you want to start your logo. Hello class. Boleh? Oh ada. Dia sebenarnya basic is shiny plastic. Tapi the texture we replace the red color by logo. Alright guys, boleh? Okay. Alright, show all. Show apa? Boleh buat lagi ke ni? Ada sikit lagi part. Okay, I save dulu apa-apa lah. I save dulu. Right. So, this one ya, nanti. Okay, bila you dah siap ni. Okay, this is good. Macam rather than you show, macam takkanlah you send to your, explain to your friend. Ini you can see my solid work kan? Trust. Can see eh? Takkanlah you nak present yes. Like this kan? Takkan you nak present like this, takkan. Tapi orang nak tengok what is the final look of the product kan? Nanti you want to promote your product, to make your product stand out. Tapi I hope you guys, you learn something. You use this software, you want me to make it like this. Itulah class. Hello class. Outstanding kan?
Good.
So that's a good about product rendering eh. So make use of it. Eh? Take the opportunity of your, because you dah penat. You already done the solid work assembly file. Eh? So take the advantage to do this thing. Okay, yang ni you can render. Nanti finally I show how you render final image. Okay, even like this pun you boleh snapshot to your client. Eh? If you leave your laptop, later on dia akan render much better. Pasal dia real time ni. Dia use your GPU and your CPU runner. Tetapi make sure RAM guys you have at least 8 lah. I suggest you lah. Nasihat. Kalau you 4 RAM tu, I think sakit juga. Okay, take my advice. Okay, sekarang ni actually there's one thing. Okay, I save this file. Okay, to final render later on, I want to show another thing. Because remember that this thing dynamic link dengan SolidWorks. Nampak tak? Class. Hello class. Dynamic link dengan SolidWorks kan? Okay, take my hero. Dynamic link. This one exploded. Okay. SolidWorks. Collapse mode. Collapse eh? Ni collapse kan? You know kan? This thing collapse exploded. I hope you know you dah belajar dulu kan? Okay. Kita boleh update to KeyShot. How do we do that? Nampak tak? Make sure you install the plugin as I told you earlier yang LiveLink plugin. Nampak tak? The second one to update to KeyShot. Can you see that one? In SolidWorks. Can you see guys?
Yes.
Update. Yes. Click dulu. You click update, tunggu juga. Dia nak baca dulu eh. Tunggu sampai dia stop highlighting ni. Dia baca dulu sampai dia tak highlight balik that button. You mean dia dah read lah. Alright. In KeyShot kita buka. Okay, nampak tak? Dia habis. Tadi exploded kan? Can you see my KeyShot now?
Yes, can.
Dia dynamic link, dia live link eh. Alright? So kita boleh go for exploded, kita boleh link. That's a good thing going on the live link. So you want to go for exploded mode? You want to go for exploded mode, exploded. Nampak eh? Nice eh? Kalau you can present in the world. Show your client something like that. Okay? Alright class, boleh lagi tak? Boleh? Channel boleh ayo continue lagi. Boleh buat lagi eh? Boleh? Boleh?
Boleh.
Boleh. Right, good. Okay. Lee Jong, you still recording eh? Yang lain-lain pun still recording ya? Yeah. Alright, good. Alright, okay, the next, okay, I save this one. Okay, my next step, bila you dah assign material lighting, okay, lighting belum lagi. The next step is we want to put a backplate image. Okay, kita nak simulate like in the real thing. We want to show to our client eh, we want to make. Okay, how to do that in SolidWorks? Okay, I already have, I just want to share you the file that I have here. Ini also you play download from internet eh. Kalau internet apa dalam Google you cakap backplate eh. Dalam Google you cakap backplate image, backplate. Anyway guys, yang I cakap tadi pixel eh. Hold on, pixel. P-E-X-E-L. Pixel. Boleh nampak my browser? Pixel ni good guys. Pixel. Pixels.com. Ini semua the professional photographer they upload dia punya ni. Macam you cakap lah concrete floor ke, apa nama tu? Concrete floor. Skateboard on the what? On the what floor? Concrete floor lah kan? Concrete floor. Sometimes tengok depend that suits you lah. You tengok, okay. They have a lot of picture. All this image ni is kind high quality. Tapi yang ni tak lah. Yang ni, you cari lah bro banyak lot image. Yang you rasa it match with your concrete floor, you cakap low angle. Low angle, low angle ni low view, eh? Low angle view. It depends sometimes. That's why your creativity, I think. Eh? Dia ada banyak image you boleh download. Tapi you kena credit eh? The owner of this photo. Eh? Kadang-kadang kalau you publish you punya work, kalau you tak credit the owner, then you publish, sometimes dia boleh sue you juga, tau, be careful. Eh? Tapi at least you credit. Eh? Macam ni, you want to letak dekat sini. Macam apa? Ni, this one, macam you want to put a skateboard on. Nampak tak? Ni more dramatic. Nampak tak? The people, maybe that skateboard at the bottom here, kan? Skateboard at the bottom here. You can do this one. This one is high resolution. You simply download. Okay, but mine, I don't want to use this one. Mine is different. I want to share your mine is this one. I already download. I think I already show on my sample work, again. Under texture, what is it? Sepatut ada backplate. Ah, backplate. Okay, I share your backplate. Hello guys, ini nampak eh? Boleh nampak tak sebenarnya? Backplate. Ini I show you sample works previously kan? Okay? It's just a photo that I superimpose with my skateboard. Nampak kan? Put my skateboard here. Kita try simulate like now. Ini something we can impress eh? We can impress to show the client eh? Hopefully when guys you graduate nanti you soon you going to become design engineer eh? InsyaAllah maybe. You are design consultant eh? You tell product nanti dia nampak. You tell student oh good your portfolio. You put you into your portfolio. You able to do not just design, you can do to ni lah. To visualize it as well eh? Use this ni lah your capability. Okay, how do we do that? Backplate, okay. Okay, I make an assembly mode. Ah. I want to make an assembly mode. Okay, another thing before that, under scene, eh? Okay, I have made sure sometimes we want to make sure our skateboard is thick on the ground. Because remember, as I told you at the beginning tadi, under environment, if I go for ground shadow, nampak ground shadow, you nampak tak? My ground shadow, can you see nampak tak ada? This is ground shadow, nampak tak? Ground shadow tu is something like up, eh? It's not at our wheel, betul tak? Eh? Bottom of our wheel, betul tak? Can you see that? Something not right. You mean that kita punya position of skateboard is beneath the ground. Dia makan dalam sikit. Nampak tak? This is a ground shadow. Can you see that? Eh? Like the ground shadow is there. So to make sure, okay, I on balik eh. Ground shadow is on to look where is my ground shadow. So I got to position my skateboard. Okay, I go to how to select everything here. So make sure you under exploded. You select everything. You negative, okay, nampak? Exploded view ni the whole thing, nampak? You punya whole component. You right click at it and you select move. Move, you mean you move. You want to move it, okay, I can move it by manually like that and make sure I can evaluate. Sometimes you can use advance, I can snap to the ground. Sometimes it's good, sometimes it's snap, sometimes it's not snap to the ground, sometimes it's still floating, nampak? Like mine is still floating. I say, mean I got to another move it again manually to betul-betul the stick at the ground. So how do we betul-betul the stick on the ground manually? So you click on the, okay, make sure that, okay. From here, I go to camera. There's a camera view. The camera, we go for, I go. Let's say I go for front. Eh? You can change the view. Eh? Under camera, you want to go standard view. I go for front. It's a front view of my skateboard. Apa lah? Satu lagi, I want to set my camera to be orthographic, eh? Not static. Default is orthographic because orthographic is good for me to know position of my ground and is it stick on the ground. Okay, but another on camera, I want to say make sure ground grip is there. You take note of this. Eh? Ground grid is there. Mean ground grid tu, well, dia akan aiding you, your guide, where is your ground position. Nampak tak ada line eh? Kalau betul-betul carefully ni ada line, this is my ground grid. So, I want to move my object. I select the whole exploded view and I move it. Okay, nampak tak I move it? Nampak kita ada picture ni? Make sure your translate is on eh? Translate is on. Sometimes your translate to off eh? Make sure try nampak you ada translate on. So, I bring it. So I got to manual. Nampak tak ada yang green button? I have to manually. Sometimes dia tak snap on the ground eh? I make sure they snap on the ground. Okay, after it's nice position on the ground, then I click okay, my position is there. Okay, now it's my view. It's not perspective, right? This is orthographic. Make sure under camera, I make sure perspective, make sure you are in perspective mode. You can go for your camera orthographic. Orthography is more realistic. Perspective is more realistic. Go for realistic, so that's your perspective. Nampak my ground grid. Another my ground grid is on. Kalau you off your ground grid, nanti it's hard for me to match my back plate tadi yang gambar tadi, the image with mine. Make sure my ground grid is on, then I can match my ground grid dengan my back plate punya ini. Alright, guys, boleh buat eh? Okay, sekarang ni, how do we put the back plate? Okay, the back plate, make sure it's, okay, I save dulu my file here. I save my file. Alright, remember, first under your left panel here, we have material colors, right? Texture, environment, I want to show, okay. Backplate, nampak tak? The fifth one, backplate. Nampak tak guys, eh? Backplate. Okay, backplate. You can use standard backplate by the Keyshot, but the standard backplate is not what I want. Tak ada. Ataupun, I can simply drop my folder backplate here. Okay, you can see my folder backplate ni. I drag my backplate nampak. You buka your folder backplate, you just drag your image of your backplate to your scenery of your keyshot. So it will be put stick on that. Nampak tak? Can you see my keyshot ada backplate? Plus.
Nampak, nampak.
Right. Okay, sekarang ni kita a matter of matching lah. Nampak tak saya punya ground grid nampak? Matching lah. You matching kan? Tapi sekarang ni, I want to match. Nampak tak? The patio of my image. Patio punya floor kan? Kita punya the image of our background ni. The floor kan? Dia ada patio of the, what you call it? The brick, brick. The brick punya line kan? Kita make sure that kita punya perspective tu matching. Nah, macam ini tu perspective tak kena lah. You kena match lah. Nampak tak? Grid line kan? Can you see the grid line of the image? Dia kan as perspective, dia kan converging toward to the end. Betul lah kan? Converging. To make sure you punya grid line of your ni matching the line perspective of the tu. Faham eh? Ini your based on you punya ni lah, you punya judgement. Nampak lah macam ni. Okay, sekarang ni. Okay, this is nice. Okay. This is okay, okay, before that, I get it to zoom in. Pasal the proportionate eh, the, of the my skateboard tak proportionate. I need to zoom in bigger lah. Scroll down my width, make it bigger. Okay, this is nice. Like that. Okay, this is nice. Okay, now, I want, okay, then I adjust my, maybe my angle of perspective you drag by left bottom arm to match the perspective of the patio and my grid line of my ground, match the perspective. Okay, you satisfied with this one? Okay, then, okay, now it's matter kita in term of our camera view. Okay, let's say I make it, okay, this about appropriate size, right? Okay, this is our camera view. So I want, okay, guys, another thing, eh? Boleh buat, eh, guys? Saya ni macam little bit fast to catch up time ni, boleh? Dah pukul 5 dah.
Boleh, boleh.
Boleh, boleh. Alright, nanti you record, you boleh repeat.
Boleh.
Yeah, recording smooth, eh, guys?
Yes, yes, yes.
Penat nanti saya. Okay, sekarang ni, this one. I can lock safe camera view. Okay, the next step after you put your backplate before you to now set with your camera view. Camera view kita boleh lock. Eh? Where is camera? Camera under your right panel. Not material, not seen. The third one, nampak? Camera. Okay, now we are in free camera. Free camera, it means kita can simply rotate. Oh, let's say I want to lock this camera view. This camera view. Okay, I want to lock. So make sure I add, nampak tak ada positif. I add a new camera. You can rename the camera. Okay, I rename it camera one. Okay, I want to lock. This is my view. I want to lock it. Nampak tak? The camera one is locked. And you, okay, camera lock, it means saya tak boleh. Nampak tak? If I bring my mouse, dia tak boleh rotate. You dah lock this view. But if I bring to free camera, I can move like that. Okay, katanya you punya view dah terkacau. Ah, ini tak match dengan the background. It's just not match background. Okay, you already save the view kan? You click camera view. There. Nampak tak? Understand eh? Guys? Alright, okay, that's one thing. Okay, this is camera view. Okay, now think, I think our, my skateboard ni, position dia horizontal, not interesting. I want to make it an angle lah. So I select the scene, select the explosive, the whole thing, explosive view the scene. I right click, move to masuk, you rotate together. I want, you can rotate like this lah, instead of using you, when I click explosive view, I go to move. You can use, ni, nampak tak, you can use, make sure you on the green icon, I green ni rotate on Z axis, nampak tak? Saya tak kucau the ni. The ni. Understand guys? The rotate on the, oh, sorry, Y axis tu. Ya, atas tu Y axis. Understand guys? Ataupun nampak sini, anda you punya ke sini, you boleh rotate. You want to rotate on 90-45? On Y saja, nampak tak? On Y. Can you see nampak ni? X, Y, Z. You are Y, eh? Keyshot Y is pointing up. Eh, bawa betul lah. Bawa interesting lah with an angle lah. Okay, nice. Okay, after we are dah go for setting. Okay, maybe kita tak satisfied dengan kita punya. Okay, okay, let's say kita dah satisfied, this good enough. Okay, I save dulu my file. Okay, make sure that our camera is a camera one already lah, eh. Then I off the grid, eh. Ground grid ni off lah, pasal, okay. Dia dah match lah. Okay, the last step is, the lighting pula tak kena. Betul tak guys? Betul tak, eh? Lighting dia tak match, tak guys? Hello, guys.
Yeah, yes.
Lighting dia tak match. Pasal lighting ni adalah default lighting. Tapi nampak tak? Can you see? Kita dah try to assimilate. Eh? We try to assimilate the same as ever. Can you see that is this background image, they have some source of lighting like yellow lighting at the right corner up there. Betul tak? Nampak tak kan?
Nampak.
Yeah. Dia ada macam kind ada satu lamp light. Okay? Lamp pole lah. Apa ni? Tiang lampu kan? Ada lamp pole with LED yang yellowish orange, eh? Macam standard lamp light. So, somewhere at the upper right corner. And also we have at the straight up there, ada satu light also from, I don't know, from somewhere, light source, kind of bluish. Nampak? So we have to assimilate that kind of graphene. Okay, to do that, okay. Because as I mentioned in K4, K4 they use the standard now. Pasal ID4, they use the standard yang ni. This order, okay. If you look under tab here, under your left panel, under environment, not backplate. Backplate where you put your image or you can drag drop your backplate image. Under environment, you can use lighting. Environment, you have 3-point lighting. Okay, I don't want you to go on this. I don't want you to go on this one. You play drag drop, I can use this. You drag drop, you different. Tapi this, even this ni pun also does not mesh. Tak mesh. I want to use, you use the basic environment setting to mesh the background. Okay, to do that, okay, focus. Okay, listen carefully. Okay, here, after you done, okay, let me save the room. After I put this, then kemudian under tab here, on the right panel, you ada scene, material, camera, nampak tak? Environment, not environment, okay, yes, environment, not lighting guy, do not confuse, not lighting, environment what I'm talking about. Environment ni, nampak tak, the default, they using the HDRI, this is environment yang startup ni lighting. I don't want to use this standard because the lighting ni does not mesh. Nampak, kita have shadow, tapi does not mesh with our environment. I want to create my own. Okay, to do that, nampak eh? Under this environment ni, I click, I add my own, nampak? That is positive, you know? Macam tadi kita add macam ni, eh? You have a listing, eh? Kita add, I click blank, blank environment, nampak tak? Blank environment. Guys, nampak tak? Nampak tak kita punya produk? Blank environment, I set my own, I think. So, the blank environment before, total kali ni is not pure black, this kind like dark grey lah. Nampak tak? Dark grey. Eh? Dark grey. Dark grey. Kalau I can change the color of ini, kalau I change pure black, kalau if I change my environment, new environment, blah, blah, blah. Nampak tak? Our product totally black. There is no point of light. Background is nothing. Background is just superimposed, kan? The backplate is that not contribute. We have to simulate this environment that control our lighting. Because it's totally black, right? Okay, no. Okay, sky is totally black. Tak ada lighting. No. Okay, sekarang ni, what I have to do, I have to add light. Okay, make it okay. Dark. Okay, let's say I make dark black. Now I want to, how do we add light dalam our environment ni? Eh? So I go nampak eh? Here ni under. Okay, our main asalnya at the beginning is totally is no source of lighting lah. So nampak kat sini you add pin ni. Add pin ni. If I click add pin ni, it add one source of light. Nampak tak? Okay, this light ni, pasal dia kan, all this black color and one source, this source of light is at the center of my rectangular image. Dia macam like spherical wrapping, guys. Spherical wrapping. This point of light actually at my longitudinal, at the ground plane. Tak nampak sangat. So, I got to move little bit the light macam ni. I got to move the put, nampak. If I move the light little bit up, nampak tak? That is a shadowing. Nampak tak? Can you see, guys?
Yes, can.
This source of light. Dia macam like omni light. It's a point light. Eh? If I move, okay. If I bring it to the left, nampak? Betul tak shadow? I want to simulate yang kita satu persatu, step by step. I want to simulate the yellow light at the upper right corner. Betul tak shadow ni? Tak betul kan? Okay, so I have to move it to the right. Betul tak? Itulah pasal yellow light from the right, kan? So the shadow yellow light from the left, sorry, upper left corner. So the shadow project to the right. Itulah. Nampak tak the position of lighting ni?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. What is the color of the light? Yellow, kan?
Yeah.
So how do you change? Okay. This pin masih made we add light. The color is like, how do you control the color? Nampak tak color? You change the color to something yellowish lah. Play around lah dengan color. You play around with color. You pick yellowish orange. Okay, you play around dengan color. Okay, katakan you want to go for a little bit yellow. Eh? Ini tedious sikit lah, guys. You kena your creativity lah. Eh? Yellow color. Okay. You click okay. Okay, tetapi sekarang, why is it still not? Dia tak really brighten the surface. Pasal nampak tak? Brightness. Can you see the brightness? Eh? Let's say brightness increase 5 by 5. Increase 5 minute. 5 times. Nampak tak? Default is one. You mean like the point the light punya what illumine punya apa illuminance punya power lah in term of watt or something like that. Brightness macam you punya I make it 5. Default is one. Nampak tak? Kan also Louis kan? Hello class. Are you listening or not? Boleh faham?
Yes.
Right, okay?
Yes.
Fine. Okay, kalau you put 50, janganlah too bright lah kan? Tak boleh lah. Come on lah, biologik eh. Tak boleh lah. Kalau you let's go for 10. Ini try another lah. kind of like little bit tedious. Okay, let's say I go for 7. Kind of like that. Okay, this simulate like me. Okay, you can play around. Kalau okay, you can control the position. You can drag here. Also, you can control the light position. Nampak sini. You have azimuth and elevation. Azimuth is left and right. Left and right. Nampak tak? You can control. Now, azimuth is left and right. Macam, I think that one is not okay. It's about like this. Macam light to maybe okay here. Elevation is up and down, up and down. Takkan you, kalau you buat macam ni, you punya light ni dah bottom plane tau. Sebab tak ada, dia pasal bottom plane tu, you punya ground plane, bottom. You bring azimuth elevation, you mean it's up. It's pasal dia upper left corner, it's little bit up. Okay, pro. That is, kalau you put like this, dia ada totally yang macam up sangat. Dia dah up sangat, tapi you put little bit something up. Okay, that's your, okay, you can control. Okay, you have, I don't have time to explain detail ya. You can control fall off. Fall off mean you punya, kalau I put my fall off dimmer, dia macam kind ada fall off tau eh. No, default is point one. Kalau you, remain it as default lah. Remain it as default. Okay, lima. So, okay, so this kind that already simulate lah, the light yang yellow light. Okay, let me save dulu. Okay, now you want to do, I have another light. Can you see my image? That is another light, like blue, your light, apa, bluish, yellow, apa, white, bluish color on the directly straight up here. Nampak tak? Nampak tak from the
yes.
Backlit? Okay, I add another one, add another pin, mean add another one. Nampak tak? This is the first icon, add another pin, that's one, okay? Same procedure macam tadi. Okay, that's now is your pin number two. Your second point of light, I want to simulate there. Okay, where is it? This somewhere up there. Okay, I just use this one. I control the elevation saja. I control the elevation somewhere up there. Okay, control up. Okay, katakan you want to tap. Okay, you want to pasal you ada dua light. Satu light pin one, light yang tu. That lighting tu dah kacau your shadow of your punya second light. You can off dulu for a while. Off your light one tadi. Yang yellow light you off for a while. You want to focus on the shadow on the second light. Okay, I off dulu. Nampak tak? I unclick, I mean I off it. Okay, then that light tu, okay. I tengok, I want to simulate the shadow also must be mesh eh. Okay, make sure the brightness, I put it little bit like 5 dulu. Okay, let's go for kita punya in term of, okay, if I bring it around lagi, you tengok the shadow, where is the shadow? The shadow, nampak tak? Betul tak? Betul kan? Ini macam from the upper right corner, right? So, means kita in the middle eh. In the middle. You can play around. Macam the shadow, maybe here. It's not right. Okay, you can simulate as long the mesh macam dia from straight up there. I think straight up there will be at the center. If I'm not mistaken, kalau I bring it up, yeah, it should be at up here. And up little bit. And kalau ni betul, dia like dome rack lah. Dia bukan dome. Kalau up ni betul-betul ceiling of the dome. Dia is somewhere here. Somewhere, but in term of position your shadow. Okay, you can do. You can let ni boleh nampak pasal. Okay, you can see that. You can see nampak sikit shadow. Right? Okay, you boleh control by. Okay, let's say the level is good. You want to go for azimuth. Azimuth, so you play around left and right. Okay, just like about right. Okay, I think that's about. Okay, let's say I hold on here. Then kemudian, okay, the elevation tu I make it. Little bit up. You can simulate from the back there. Okay, I think this one is good enough. Boleh nampak guys eh? Good enough. The position of your shadow there from there. Faham ke? Boleh eh?
Boleh.
Elevation tu saya make it lower sikit. Okay, pasal tadi I off the yellow light. So I on again eh? The combine again. I on the combine. So I think it's about nice lah. Okay, maybe the light yang ni is too bright. I make a yang ni brightest. Okay, the radius ni, radius is how much eh? Kalau katakan my pin number one, the size of you punya. Kalau I make my radius is 1, you produce a more you punya light source, you punya point dia kecil eh? Kalau the before is 20 eh? 20 it depends. The radius is size you punya light source lah. You can control it based on that. Ni guys, I give you the rough lah. Sebenarnya setting ni takes time lah. Because we don't have time to do. Kita kena some, kita cakap more on apa, dedicated punya work lah. You kena into it. Spend time with it. Tengok, oh, mesh that the light. I hope you understand. Faham tak guys? Eh? I don't have time lah to explain everything. Faham?
Yeah.
Faham. Okay, satu lagi you boleh buat letak juga. Sometimes, okay. You have, okay, this is a basic. Macam ni dia tak nampak sangat. Tak apalah, you boleh adjust. I hope you understand. So, that's how we adjust. Okay, let's say you are done with this. So, you can do rendering lah. You can do rendering. Bisa ni, guys, I have to save time. Banyak lah. You kena setting lah. Ini you intuit lah. You play, you can play around with this software later. You can do it and you render. Okay, how do we make a final render? You can put more than one product here lah. So, only one skateboard, you can move. Maybe another skateboard, another design can show to your client about variation of design. Okay, how do we do final render? Okay, I already save it. Okay, I already save it. Now render, okay. You want to render, apa you punya output? You want to render in A4 or you want to render in showing in the internet? Kalau internet, what is the resolution? For example, you want to show you your product internet, what is the resolution internet? Standard for high density is 1080p kan? 1080p times by 1920, itu meant for internet. Meant for internet, 1920 itu yang full HD kan? 1920, 1080, depend. Maybe you have own solution. In term of pixel of your length and width of your image, it depend how much you render it. Okay, for example, I want to go for A4. For example, you want to go for A4. For example, okay, for example, you want to render. Okay, be careful, eh? Be careful before you render. I take note. Make sure the image dulu. You tengok dulu resolution preset. Resolution preset. Kata, we don't want to go for portrait. We are in landscape, right? Landscape. Eh? Our viewport is landscape. You want to go for HD, HD 1920, 1080. Nampak sini? Can you see that 1920, 1080? So it means the view portion of your view ni must match what is your render output. Be careful, you must take note. Resolution ni kena match dulu at the end. Ini after at the end. Bila you dah finish your camera semua, you punya lighting, you match dengan background, it's done. Then kemudian your resolution preset ni, landscape, if you want to man for 1920, 1080, go for 1920, 1080. Then I want to render 1920, so I go for render. Kalau if you want go for A4, landscape A4. A4 bigger guys, eh? A4 ni, bigger sebenarnya bigger guys. Kalau if you look on the internet, kalau you man, you want to go for document. Macam my student, they want to print A4. You want to letak dalam you punya portfolio. I mean hard copy, I'm not talking about soft copy, A4 size. Kalau you tengok A4, pasal kalau for printing, you have to go for 300. Can you see my browser, boleh nampak? 300 dpi, nampak guys? 300 dpi, pasal 300 dpi is standard. Kalau A4 size for 300, you got to render 3508-2480 punya resolution. Kalau you nak print, I mean porting for hardcover. Sometimes my student, I render from that A3 size. So A3 size, you mean, you can remember I show you yang pogo stick, that one is A3. For now, I render it for near big size. Then I give to my student the PDF and they can print from the printing shop. Whether you render, kalau you want to go for A4, you print for A4 atau render A3. You save that image, then you send to the printing shop. Printing shop banyak lot outside. The cost is about RM1 dia, RM1.50 dia, RM2 dulu. Cost you, then you render it, you make sure you punya art cover paper, bukan typical A4 paper or A3 paper yang art line punya paper. You know lah kalau you buat printing punya kertas, you know. They will know, so dia macam little bit of glossy sikit. Nice, eh? You can put mount on your poster of you punya dalam room lah. You can see you punya work show to your parents and semua lah. This is my product design. Okay, kalau A4, 300, T5, kalau A3 is ready. Okay, tapi okay, file ini kalau me nak render A4, lama sikit lah. Okay, I show you, tapi tak, yeah. Okay, if I render for A4, make sure, yeah. Be careful, need first. Landscape, A4, make sure this one, the viewport also A4, because you nak tengok the image. Kemudian render, lastly render, then you go on bar sekali, the render tu, render one. So you go, bila dia open the render compartment, nampak eh? This one nampak eh guys? Hello guys. Okay. Output. Okay, output. Where is the output? Okay, you name. Apa you punya name? You cakap you punya, I already have a skateboard. You name lah you punya name of file skateboard 3, eh? Skateboard 3. Okay, what you want ni? JPEG ni, format. JPEG. Go for JPEG lah. PNG ni okay. PNG is good quality, eh? Default JPEG lah. Let's go for JPEG. Tapi JPEG yang background, kalau PNG macam saya cakap logo, background white, dia become transparent. That's good. Tetapi yang this one for JPEG lah. Okay, quality make sure you go for 100% lah. Quality 100%, this is where you want to render. Name, okay, this is a folder where you want to render. Folder is the folder where you want to render. You want to render here, you put into what folder of your, I want to put into my skateboard folder, rendering. Then I name it rendering skateboard 3. Okay, I already select the folder, and the file name is skateboard 3. Then you render lah. Then you render. Ah no, before guys, sorry guys, something that I missed before. Hold on, hold on. Something before that, you want to produce high quality in your lighting. Before that, sorry guys, eh. Before that, finalize one. Before you render, this one I forgot, guys. Ini, ini, be careful ni. Lighting ni, take note guys, eh. Before you render, last kali, go to product. Ini adalah setting. This is the setting. Kalau you go for basic, you punya actually quality of rendering is not good enough. If you want to go high quality, memang they really calculate the shadowing, the global animation, go for product. Product. This is the final last product. So, ni dia dia akan setting you punya render based on product. Even you leave dalam you, in your viewport or effect shot, dia render high quality. Tapi for you to editing like we doing just now, make sure pasal kerja save memory. Go to basic dulu. After finalize before you render, go to product. Bila you product, memang dia dah calculate. Nampak dia tick the global animation, ground animation, everything is on. Exceptional. Kalau you go for basic, I mean the lighting, yang ni off, only shadow saja. Global animation is not on. Global animation, I mean the real light, I mean, the global, really calculate physics lighting. The light bounce each other. The light simulate everything. Make sure this, take note. Mesti click at product. Eh? Product, then you go for tadi image, tadi F4, then you go for render. Then you go for render, you, where you render it tadi. Then you click render lah. Click render. Itulah cakap guys, kalau pasal this one I show F4 300 dpi 3500 resolution tadi berapa eh? It takes time a little bit lah, you have to ni. Tapi for you guys for portfolio, kalau you want to send your portfolio to your lecturer in term of just for apa kita cakap, not for main for printing, not for hard copy. For printing of course you can have take higher resolution 300 dpi. For just for share on the internet, I think you guys can go for full HD, it's okay, 1920 and 1080. Understand what I'm talking about, guys? Faham, eh?
Faham.
Nampak ada rendering 3% semua. Tak apalah, kita tak payah wait for this. You render, bila dia say, you save, dia akan save, eh? You boleh save balik. After you finish rendering, make sure definitely 100% done. You boleh save again here. You can save kat sini, okay? Guys, I make it short, eh? So, after ni, boleh guys, boleh, eh? I stop the rendering. I mean, you render it. Guys, you understand or not? So, bila dah final quality, okay, then you can go you punya rendering yang macam like I show you in macam ni lah. Boleh, can you see yang this one nampak eh? Ni dah final rendering. Ini F4 size guys, kan? Nampak besar lah. F4. This F4. Kalau you print F4 memang cantik lah, nice. Memang sharp pasal 300 dpi. Tapi for internet, kalau you want to share you punya work to client kadang-kadang quick one, tak payah. Do not go for high resolution lah. For full HD is okay. It's up to you what solution you want to choose. Okay? Okay, final one eh, final one. It's not yet. Okay, final one. Sometimes you punya product, you want, okay. Then, okay, let me save ni dulu. Let me save ni dulu. I want to off my backplate eh. I want to off, yang ni, I don't want my backplate. Backplate, backplate, where is my image backplate? How do I dah tak boleh recall. How do I delete my backplate? Orang kasi. How do I delete my backplate? Okay, so sorry. Okay, I off in here. Environment, okay, this one another thing. Eh? Background, backplate image there. Okay, you can put my backplate. Background, I don't want to be my plate. This one for just color, basic macam tadi. Default tadi. And my environment, I want to use the standard yang 3-point environment. Make sure you're on environment, or you want to use the standard. Ini another, this one another option. I want to render 360 degree virtual. Eh? You boleh rotate, you send to your client, you punya works. I don't want to be no ground shadow floating on the air, and also I want to my image solution ni I want to be standard. This one just to show you. Okay, my lighting is not environment lighting is not. Hold on, my environment, I put my, okay, never mind. Okay, this one, my camera, okay, this one, I just off it. Make sure environment, so I go for lighting environment, sorry. Lighting environment, yeah, this is my lighting environment. Tadi camera saya dah lock, eh? Camera saya dah lock, never mind. You can, this one can pre-camera. Okay, another, beside you render steep image macam you put a backplate, tadi that one meant for you to explain what your product to simulate real thing, right? You also can send to your client in term of virtual. You render 360 degree. I mean you render so you can send you punya to your client, dia can browse, dia boleh rotate around like that. Macam yang tadi still image and just static image. You can also name. Can you see this one KeyShot XVR? Can you see this one? Bottom there. KeyShot XR. Hello guys. Are you listening or not? Still on lagi eh? Boleh keras? Boleh eh? Boleh buat lagi eh? Sikit lagi. Sabar sikit. Keyshot XR. XR. Keyshot ni virtual reality lah eh? You click. You can render, you can send to your client. Keyshot XVR. Okay, you want to make it, you want to your product to be turntable like this ke? Turntable, I mean you can only, your client can see your product, you're pushing like that. Only one axis only. Turntable. Or you want it to be spherical. Spherical, you can ROS or, tapi dia render banyak image lah. Takes little bit longer lah. Or you want to make it semi-spherical, tapi I go for spherical. Eh? Spherical 360 degree. I mean you boleh, your client boleh, you send, eh? Then you render it. Okay, you just click it. Dia ada wizard. It's wizard. Eh? You cakap environment. Okay, I mean your settle point of your rotation. You want to go for environment or object? Like, let's go for object. Kalau object, okay, I go for environment. I mean the focus at center. Okay, environment. Then I click next. Then okay, distance only. Okay, you leave it default lah, because I don't have to explain everything detail. Just basically leave it default. Then you click next. Okay, horizontal frame, okay. This is how you control. Kalau you horizontal frame ni, eh, vertical frame, you put banyak eh. Lagi, when after you finish render, it become more smoother. More smoother in term of the browse macam like the smooth one. Smooth one, smooth one. Tapi, before I go to next, I want to make sure, okay, this is the width. View resolution. Okay, I go so back. Back ni in term of horizontal frame. The more you increase, the more smoother the you punya browse 360 degree. Vertical frame also you can make. Let's say we go for default. Right? Let's say we go for default. We go to next. This is the resolution. Okay, this is where you ni. Eh? Macam folder where you want to render you punya 360 degree view. Okay, you can go for, do not put it too high lah. Maybe you go for 800, let's go for 800 something, or maybe 5. Ini dia based on resolution. Why I put 800 based on you punya resolution yang I set tadi. Tadi I set to berapa resolution eh. You can set, kalau you want it to make square, you set you punya resolution yang tadi, image resolution. Kalau I put 800, dia akan ikut ratio dia punya width and length. Okay, then, okay, let's say go find that. Then you just render where the one you want to ni, you go to which folder that you want to. Okay, if I click render, if I click render now, then it will render image by image. Okay, you just close it and leave it like that. Nampak tak? Can you see that? The render image by image. Okay, image that I have 162 from my doing 500. So you have to wait a little bit for a while. This one's also good. Eh? Okay, this the render image one. Then you wait, then the render image two. They render frame by frame. They render frame by frame. They render frame by frame. Hold on for a while. Eh? They render frame by frame. Ini not, this is not for what we call it. Not for kita superimpose dengan backplate just now. Eh? The, not for poster for apa for to for advertise your product. This is for to share with your client, to communicate with your group member, to maybe your client want to see browse how the component you, they can rotate it with this photo realistic from Keyshot based on this GI rendering. So you have to wait. This one frame 3, nampak tak? You have frame 3. After you have done that, okay. Okay, I don't save time eh. Actually sampai 162. Don't eh. For me, I suggest you jangan buat high resolution. Go for 500 or 800, something like that. After you have done it, okay, I just make it short. Okay, after you have done, you save what file. So I want to see the, show you the folder, where is it? That's my one of my sample animation eh, yang render. Dia akan together like this guy. Can you see this one, my folder? Eh? You can see my folder. Eh? This is why I render my Keyshot XVR. Do you know about folder ni? Eh? Okay, okay, they render all this frame. Eh? They put all this one. Eh? So you just open the file. They are come together. You send your client these two folder. The folder of the frame and the file. Instruction, skateboard. Yeah, skateboard and yeah. They become HTML file. Become web browser file. So must you must attach them also the folder of the file. Okay, you send that one. I share the browser. Can you see the browser here? Nampak guys? Nampak tak? Hello, class.
Nampak.
Nampak? I boleh drag. Nampak tak? Yang ni I buat tak smooth eh, tadi. Kalau you pakai smooth and you resolution and eh, vertical and horizontal frame tadi, you boleh control. You mean your browser, your client dia boleh slow. Dia boleh look or this one. Tapi kalau you want a bigger size, much better lah. Tapi takes time a bit. Depend on you punya laptop lah, your CPU and your graphic card. You boleh browse through 360 degree. Okay guys, I hope you understand, you take note apa yang saya cakap. Okay, I hope apa yang saya ajar ni memberi manfaat kepada awak semua tentang okay, ini akan saya listening. I hope you understand about basically ini. Basically, you can make use of this thing lah about product rendering and visualization. Eh. Okay guys, I think that's all for my presentation. Ada apa-apa question?
Tak ada.
Okay, so kalau tak ada,
Yeah.
I think that's all. Eh? Thank you for your participation, your cooperation. And John, you are you recording? Semua ada recording, okay tak?
Ya, yeah, ada.
Alright, thank you very much.
Boleh stop, boleh stop, ma'am.
Boleh, then you can upload to me as soon as possible.